Welcome to another exciting episode of Andy's Talk Show. This week, we do something really interesting and very spooky. Yes, I'm going to be taking a spelling test. And don't be afraid to precipitate at home, also, if you're not scared to spell. See, I already spelled the word dog. See, you're going to be able to see everything. You're going to see my face, see me sweat. And you're going to be able to see what I spell down here, see? This screen. See, you understand? Isn't modern technology wonderful? Yes. Okay, I need to talk to my director, who is an excellent speller, by the way. Oh, see this camera here, shoot. I need to talk to him. I just moved the camera. Can't do that, Andy. Can't do it. Can't do it. Alright. Director, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Andy.
I can hear you.
That's nice.
Okay. Now, dog, D-O-G. Did I do that one right?
I believe so.
Thank you. Okay, what's next?
I believe the next word is fire truck.
Fire truck. Fire. Fire truck.
That's correct, Andy. You're good.
I'm going to ace this.
Next word is announce.
What word?
Word.
What word?
Announce.
Announce! Announce.
Very good.
Very good. Did I get that one right?
Yeah. Okay, I believe we
kicking
have...
Kicking butt.
Yeah, we have someone else here that wants you to spell a certain word.
If I guess their voice, do I get an extra 5 points?
Yes.
I love muffin.
Muffin?
Love muffin.
I don't think our TV audience heard that.
Hi, my stud. Will you please spell a word for me?
Yes.
Who am I?
Who am I? Jess! It's Jess! 5 points.
Well, very good, Andy. What I would like for you to spell...
Duct tape? Can I spell duct tape?
After plate tectonics.
What was that word again, please?
Plate tectonics.
Plate tectonics. Plate.
The shifting of rocks, I believe.
The shifting of rocks, she believes. Plate tectonics. I don't care. Plate tectonics.
You got it going on, that's right.
All right. She's a rapper chick. Don't hold that against her, though. Next word, please, Mr. Director, sir.
City Council.
City Council. City Council.
Absolutely correct.
How about MCAT? I can spell MCAT.
Are you sure?
Just go on.
Spell encyclopedia.
Encyclopedia.
Yes.
Encyclopedia.
Okay. Noah, I believe there is a difference between an encyclopedia and a dictionary. But that's close enough. Okay. Would you like another word, Andy?
Shoot! No bad words.
Spell.
This is a good pure show. Technotronic. Come on, David Letterman is coming soon.
Technotronic.
It's August 30th, you know. Techno what?
Tronic.
Technotronic. Just stay out of this.
Hey, hey.
Technotronic. Factory music.
Factory, huh?
I can't see that. For a reason. Okay. Shoot! One more. No, two more. Couple more. Come on, do an easy one. These are getting harder.
Pathetic.
Pathetic. Oh yeah, I nailed that one.
That's wrong, Andy.
Oh, sorry. Oh.
Yeah, I even put the CD in. I believe. Okay. Want me to start on the computer? No, it's pretty bad.
She's gonna get you.
Excuse me for interrupting,
yes?
But I was cable casting. I look on the screen and I see my name and Jake and Lori.
Uh-huh.
Hello. What's that mean, partner?
Nothing. Go on, Jake. Come
on. I know where you live, man.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm losing control of the show, folks.
One last word, Andy.
Okay.
Spell.
Volkswagen.
That's right. Volkswagen. Spell it.
Ha!
That's
That's wrong. No, you have to spell the whole thing.
The whole thing?
Yes.
Volkswagen. Whoops. Oh. There you go. Volts pickup.
No, but I think you're close.
Well, thank you. Come on, do one more. I can do this.
Oh, all right. Spell. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. I can't even say it.
Duh! Alright, in a moment, Jess Jones, live! No, well, kinda live. Well, I think she's breathing.
My name is Elzebub.
Oh!
Hi.
This is Andy's talk show. We just did the spelling thing just a minute ago. Hope you enjoyed that. Well, for all you Phillies out there, I have somebody very important to give unto you. It's Cinnamon, Jess Jones. Come on down, Jess Jones. Jess Jones, come on down. Come on down, Jess Jones.
I'm coming.
Jess Jones, in purple today. You're looking very lovely.
Yes, yes. Oh, my God. I forgot. I'm on Annie's talk show. I'm incognito.
Yep. You gotta hide yourself. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, there he is. You look like a little Eskimo.
I'm famous now. I have to keep a low
profile.
Yeah,
I know. A low profile. You know, I was attacked by a whole bunch of third graders. It was just terrible.
Yes, that's happened before.
Yeah.
So you work here at MCAT, don't you? You work here at MCAT.
I used to until I became famous, which is just now. So.
Okay.
Yeah. Who knew?
Famous, my butt. My guests are more famous than I am. Excuse me, I'm gonna move the mic around here. Of course, that's okay, because who wants to be famous? Ha! Okay, so, Jess Jones, gee whiz. I had a whole list of questions for you. I think I can remember a few of them. What do you think is the major problem with America's youth today? The biggest problem?
They don't watch enough Madonna videos. Yeah, it's gotta
She's
be it.
She's been thinking about these questions for way too long. What do you want, Jake?
Okay, just wondering. He's looking at us oddly. Okay, question number two. If you were to fight for the right to party, would you use a large club or a jar of mayonnaise?
I'd have to say a jar of mayonnaise. Take a bite out of crime.
Okay. This Jenna. Was pre-rehearsed. This was not pre-rehearsed. She is just always like this. So, we want to find the real Jess Jones.
God, I'm good.
Yes, I know. We should be on radio.
Just
Jess Jones and Andy. Together again. Back for one more appearance at the Stupidity Lounge.
Okay, question number three. Let's see. Have you ever gotten excited to eat pork chops?
Andy?
Yes?
I'm feeling flippant that you asked me that question. Because it happens all the time. Those pork chops, they just get the best of me.
She also watches extremely too much television and too many Madonna videos.
Hey, it's gotta be done. Saturday Night Live.
Saturday Night Live.
Coffee Talk.
Coffee Talk. Is that like one of your favorite shows?
Lately haven't been able to watch it, but yes.
Why not?
Because you call me every night and it gets annoying.
Yeah, I know how it is.
I'm getting back at you because I saw my name on the screen.
I know you saw your name on the screen. There was a reason for this, okay? Because you said a bad word on my show.
I don't know why.
And Lori's always bugging me.
Oh, she's going to get you bad for this.
No, she isn't.
I'll get him, Lori. I'll get him.
She's a fine example of
a flowering human person.
Fine person, Lori.
What's this?
What? That's Beavis and Butthead. This is Beavis, and this is Butthead, for all the people out there that don't know Beavis and Butthead by now.
And that's good, because as far as I'm concerned, they're down the road, dude.
Oh, God, no. No. Jess. So, besides working, what else have you been doing this summer besides working?
Well, I just got back from my sister's wedding. That was quite the experience.
How many brothers and sisters do you have?
Oh.
She's taking off the glasses, folks.
It's got to be done. Oh. What was that orange thing?
Your blue eyes. That is a bug.
That is Jacob, the bug.
About M&M's?
Yeah, it does every once in a while. It does mess all over the place. Mm. Sometimes it poops M&M's and Oreos and thanks, Jake.
And he's smart.
Okay. He is really smart. He is really...
He got going on.
What is it with going on, okay? Don't make me use this. These ears are very sharp.
I trust you, Andy.
This is our mascot. Spots.
You got this for your graduation.
No. Oh, yeah. I got a dog for my...
He's seen
Jake,
green.
This isn't court TV, okay?
One too many cans of Mountain Dew.
I think one too many cans of turpentine, actually. Okay. Well, we gotta go. Listen, Jess, it's been a joy working with you here at MCAT this summer.
Well, sure.
Yeah, and I know you've begged me for months to be on the show, and
this
I finally got
tooted.
On.
Okay, welcome to Andy's Talk Show once again. Here we are in beautiful downtown Missoula, Burbank. No, Missoula. To begin with, we've had a very bad month, actually, here at MCAT. And as you can see behind me is Missoulian. And as you can see, it is double printed, and it's very blurry, and you can't read a single thing. So it's a Missoulian from, what day is it today? 8/17/93, and Sarah here, same problem today with the same newspaper, and pretty bad situation. A couple of weeks ago, they had an article out, an editorial saying how bad MCAT was, and down with MCAT, you know. It's a very downing MCAT kind of an article, and people have been questioning the quality of MCAT programming. Well, we're not even paid. And these people are. And they're not even printing the newspaper correctly. I don't think so. Okay? Let me tell you, if I was doing a newspaper for free, I would expect this. But people who are paid... I paid 50 cents for this sucker. And look, it's double printed. Let's see. You know, it was delivered to my front... You know, I could have picked out a new one if it was like in one of those little... What are they called? You know, those stand things? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Anyway, put 50 cents in there and then pick... Oh, this is blurry. This one's blurry. Oh, this one's fine. You know, maybe that's the way it is. But, you know, when I pay 50 cents for a newspaper to be delivered to my door, I expect it to be at least readable. And, you know, I know people down in the Missoulian, and I don't want them to be mad at me or anything like that. It's just, start questioning your own principles before you start questioning ours. Okay, and we'll be friends! Anyway, this week we have very special guests with us. This is Queen Lizzie, and, what's your name again? They're very shy, as you can see. And they don't take Queenie jokes very well, either. You can see the chroma key behind them. They're on a cliff somewhere. This is Sarah Field and Brandy... What's her name? Walker! Yeah. Thank you, audience. That was very nice of you. So, Brandy, you're from Texas.
Texas.
What town in Texas?
Dallas.
Yeah,
really Plano, but we call it Dallas.
Dallas, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
Were you ever involved in that television show that was there?
No, I wasn't in Dallas.
When Dallas was being Dallas'd.
But it wasn't filmed in Dallas, really. Just filmed in California, mostly.
Television lies? Network television lies? Yeah, well, when it comes to beer talk, guys, we don't lie here. No, but have you ever seen JR in person?
No.
Big Stetson hat walking around town, you know.
He don't live there.
He doesn't live there?
In California.
They lied again?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well. Well, Sue Ellen used to be my... No, let's stop talking about Dallas and soap opera. It went off the air several years ago. Sing with Andy. I must apologize for last week's show. A lot of people have been asking me who that Jess person is, and I don't know either. No, she works there. She's a wonderful person. You don't know what I'm talking about. Don't you love those blank looks? Brandy. So you guys are really into country music.
You may think that, but actually we listen to alternative music too.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Like what?
Like Morrissey and Pearl Jam.
Tell us about your Morrissey experience, Sarah. Sarah's been on the show several times before.
Morrissey experience?
Yes, your Morrissey experience.
My tape disappeared.
Your tape disappeared?
It just disappeared.
Uh-huh. Well, was that for the good of the nation, or was it?
Well, I think somebody took it and burned it.
And burned it?
And burned it.
Who did that?
I don't know.
And it wasn't me.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry, I just saw a ghost. I'm really sorry about that. Okay, guys. So your Morrissey tape disappeared off the face of the earth. And I had nothing to do with this, okay? He's a fine fellow.
to a point, okay? It doesn't matter, all right? Scott, if you touch one button back there to make my horns grow or something like that. You know, there is a button that'll make us disappear. But you're not going to be doing that. Okay, so you guys are really... you've been to several concerts in Dallas, and I guess they all go there for some reason. They're drawn to Texas, is that the...
All the country ones.
Yeah, all the country ones, something like that. Hmm, very interesting. Oh, God, this show's going to... No, it's not because of you. I don't know the questions asked. I've known you, too. Well, I've known Sarah for quite a bit, and I sort of just met you. Again.
2 years ago.
2 years ago. We were on that trip to Chief Looking Glass, right?
Remember that? No.
Was that? We were attacked by flies and stuff. It was right before you left.
Oh, I went?
Yes.
Yeah.
You were there. She was high on Kool-Aid.
Oh, and you made hamburgers.
Hamburgers, that's yes. Right. And we were attacked by birds the size of...
I remember.
Yeah, that was really fun.
It was fun.
Best hamburgers ever tasted.
Mm-mm, it's because of those flies. And that swamp water putting it. Mm-mm. So I was over at your house the other day, and it was raining. It was right after the Demolition Derby, which I must say is quite an experience. I think this is where all the inbreeders go to, like, hang out. That's really... Okay, so, and I have this fascination with... animal cookies. What do you guys think about animal cookies? Be honest now. You don't have to impress me.
They're too powdery.
Hmm?
Too powdery.
Powdery?
Mm-hmm.
Get the hell out of here.
I will tomorrow.
Fine. Well, I'm looking at my watch and time's almost up. But I thank you for coming all the way to Missoula, Montana to be on my show.
That was the reason.
That's right. It was. Thank you, Brandy. Mm-hmm. Thank you, sir. I probably have you back on, like, next week, maybe. I don't know. You obsessive fans. God, I have to beat you off with clubs. Anyway, well, I'll see you next week on Andy's Talk Show. Goodbye. Hi, welcome to Andy... Which camera? Oh, hi! Welcome to Andy's Talk Show, another exciting episode. We have no director this week again. Our camera people are, you know... Actually, it's kind of like the same because we normally don't have any brains behind the program anyway. So it's no big deal.
Which is true.
Scott Duffield here at the end here. Wearing stripes and see-through pants.
Sequins. Silver sequins.
I bet I could stick my hand, right through your pen. There it goes.
Does that look real? were you looking at the camera with the lens cap on?
No.
Okay.
I was trying to, I was not pointed. Oh! See, we have a picture of Denmark and Joe Dryling.
Hi, Joe.
This is Joe Dryling. We freeze dried her and brought her here. And, she's here with us today also.
She's kind of quiet today.
She's very quiet.
Yeah.
Enjoys looking sultry.
Sultry?
My name's Joe.
I wonder how many takes it took her to get that.
Don't know.
I'm not going to try and guess.
Watch on the inside. Anyway, this is Jeanette Zarco. She's the, she's the reason everyone lives.
Oh, thank you.
She is the mother of all humanity, Joe Dryling. No.
Wait.
Jeanette Zarco! I have you on once, and look, you ruined everything. No, you've been on before, and Joe's been on.
I've been on.
This is your, you're a beginner.
I'm a beginner.
You're what we call a vidical, no. A video virgin, that's what we call you. A magnetic example of let's move on. Let's move on. I don't know what I'm speaking of. My mind is totally blank now. And
let's keep going.
Okay. Well, you guys are going to school, right?
Yeah. In unison.
Great. Yep.
Where are you going, Jeanette?
I go to Emerson College in Boston.
Boston?
Massachusetts.
Mass? Just Mass.
Mass?
Not Massachusetts. If you're from there, you're just Mass.
Mass.
Boston, so, Mass.
So goes Virginia, New Hampshire, Mass.
Good.
Very good.
You could be a real Bostonian.
Bostonian? Is that what they call them?
I think so.
Bostonian. Ew. What do they call Missoulians and Bostonians? I suppose that makes sense.
We're from Mont, I guess.
Mont? And then Norda. And over on the other side is...
I'm going to call it Wash.
Wash.
Wash?
Really? Ida. Ida, Wash, Mom.
Ida. Idaho.
Whew. How are you getting there anyway? You're going to Pacific Loop... No.
No.
Pacific something. In Tacoma, Washington.
Puget.
Puget. Puget Sound University.
Puget Sound, the university.
University of Puget Sound. And that would be on Puget Sound, right?
Defiance Point, even.
That is a...
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. And Tacoma. I've been to Seattle. It's very cool.
All right. Let's show you the sock cut today. Wayne's World.
Oh. I'm not a big Wayne's World fanatic. So.
You didn't see the movie, even?
I did, but I don't remember.
Mutiny!
Oh, it's your talk show, isn't it?
Hmm? What?
Isn't it your talk show?
What talk show?
Yeah, but that's
what a talk show!
We just have Scott and I conversation.
Oh, Joe.
Excuse me, I've seen... She's like the biggest fan. She's like the most popular person on the show, and she's like freeze-dried.
I carry around in my wallet.
Wow. She can actually fit in a little wallet. I mean, I couldn't fit a mouse in my wallet. Well, I tried once, but they pulled me over and they asked to see my wallet. And there were little mouse guts all over the place, and they were asking me why I had a mouse.
Andy!
I'm blithering. Hey, well, how's it going to the boss? Mass. Boss.
Good.
Mass.
It's fun.
It is?
Mm-hmm. Big city.
Big city.
Big city.
You're not used to living in a big city.
Now I am.
You are now.
Now I am. Yeah, I took Scott around.
Ooh. You been to Boss?
I've been to...
He came and visited me. He saw my dorm and everything. He's seen where I live.
Lucky!
He wasn't too impressed, though.
Why not? What's wrong with the dorms?
The dorm,
in
it was... The dorms were like...
the fresh, condemned?
Did the condemned fire gate come down after him or something like that?
The what?
Well, it's like a
after you walked in, I mean, it's all brick, and the gate came down. And
our dorms, the eighth floor,
mm-hmm.
There's eight floors, but you can
only
see seven. Because, seriously, you can only see seven.
Uh-huh.
The eighth floor is hidden from view. Supposedly, like, mafia or something lived up in the...
Okay.
Or it had something so that they could see. There's some reason, something like that. There's a whole bunch of stories that were in the
Jesus.
And ghost stories.
Invisible. Did they, like, put you up there because you're, like, a freshman or something like that?
Yeah.
Have you moved?
Next year?
No, I'm at the other end right where I can look out the window and get a beautiful view of Cheers.
Cool! So now you've moved from your transparent home to your, like, they take you up there and go, this is your room, and this is your couch, and it's like, there's no couch there, this is not a room, this is outside. It's like, oh, no, it'll come to you later, you know. And this is your bed, and this is your stereo, and it's like, the stereo's not here, and it's like, it's invisible. It's just pretend, it's pretend.
You're looking at the wrong camera.
Look, buddy. So,
well, see, that's probably too, since it's an acting school.
Okay.
Stuff that, you know, pretending makes it all the easier to.
This is your room. This is a mime room. You must mime everything.
Stereo.
Next year. Next. Oh, yeah, get down. More seat. No. Guess last week. I haven't told you.
Guess from last week.
They're still haunting my dreams, you know.
Oh, mine always too.
Birthdays.
Birthdays.
Woo. Joe's.
Joe's birthday was
happy boy.
August 4th. Wednesday, August 4th. He was born in 75.
Wow. Who else's birthday?
My birthday.
How old are you now?
19.
No, you're not.
Not yet. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow she's
19. Well, actually, liar. The show will be aired after.
19 years of age, I
cannot. And then the next day, Scott goes 19, too.
August 19th.
August 19th, you'll be 19.
Yes.
Whoa.
And who else is born on August the 19th, Andy? Bill.
Jay Leno.
Bill. What?
Bill?
Clinton.
Bill Clinton?
And Christian Slater.
Scott's.
Isn't that weird? This man looks like Christian Slater. And are you guys, like, twins?
What?
Our
ghosts.
Audience are ghosts.
I know things about
you. My brother's birthday was yesterday.
Really?
Yeah, and third, and then yours is tomorrow. Mm-hmm. It's like, this is like a big month for birthdays.
Yeah, my mom's birthday was this week, or month too.
Man, with all the birthdays and stuff like this. This must be a great month for bakers and the candle suppliers and
oh yes, of course.
And actually, it would be about November that would be the.
And it's quite a few November too.
Why November? Is that?
Let's see.
I think it would be November.
November would be the big
January or December.
January and February in those cold months is what I think she's saying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, somewhere in there. Yeah, it's probably a big mattress sale month is.
Is in December.
December.
And it's in January, February.
Yeah.
And 9 months.
That's probably where all the lights go out in those months, too. And there's nothing to do.
Power outages and stuff.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. There's nothing to do. So.
And there's those Christmas lights.
Yeah, those are really, they make you hot. Yes. Look at that, Sammy! Come here, Rudolph. profanity. No profanity. I'm sitting here. Okay. So you were on the show, and you were using bad language also.
Well, that's just because you asked me to.
Well, do it again.
You ever get the feeling like everything in America is just...
That was brilliant. See, it was Christian Slater with glasses.
With glasses.
Or does he wear glasses?
No, he doesn't.
Sunglasses sometimes.
Yeah, he usually... probably really has red eyes when he's wearing glasses. Can't say that on the show?
What? No, nothing.
Okay.
What's it like living so far away from home and, like, you know, I can't remember my question. What's it like just living so far away from home and,
so far
and
away
living
from
at
home?
Dome?
Well,
dome.
You have to buy things that you don't really want to buy.
Like
shampoo and stuff like that.
That's
for
a pain.
Yourself. You know, you don't get used to buying that stuff, and then you go away and you have to get that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you'd walk around with really gross hair.
Unless you use like sand or something like
that. Yeah, the money thing's a big difference.
Mm-hmm.
But
can't go to mom's house and raid the refrigerator and use the washing machine.
If you
want to
call, the washing machine's expensive. Yeah,
you have to buy your own detergent?
Yep.
You get like.
Yeah, but my mom sends me detergent in there.
Especially with your invisible closet.
No, it came in. No, my mom sent it in a
Ziploc bag with the liquid stuff.
I got a peanut butter jar.
A peanut butter jar?
Filled with detergent.
Thanks, Mom!
Where Where's the peanut butter?
Happy birthday,
hon. And
it's
white powder, so I'm probably going to get, like...
Can I get some Snuggle next year? I bet you use a lot of that detergent since your invisible closet. Your clothes get kind of dirty.
Yeah.
You never know if they're dirty, so you can wash them all the time.
So have you seen, like, Norm and...
They were filming outside. But see, we got pissed off when they film right outside there because the Performing Arts Building is right down the alley. You know if you see the little Cheers thing at the beginning?
Yeah.
And there's the building and then there's alley and it gets cut off right there. And you can kind of see a little bit, like this much of the alley. Well, if you walk straight down that alley, that's our Performing Arts Building.
Oh my God.
In the alley? That's why I didn't like Boston. Everything in the alleys.
And they film, and like hordes and hordes of people come to watch the filming, so they're all standing out around. You have to walk like 6 blocks out of your way to get to class.
Oh, Jesus.
And because they won't let you through, and they have police lines up and all
and
that.
And your invisible bike doesn't work.
Right.
Uh huh.
It's at the shop because you don't know it's broken.
That's like, I think the chain is loose. Really? Yeah, I think I busted a tire too. It's like, really? Well, I'll have to fix that up for you.
It'll only be $20.
Yeah, I'll have to use my invisible hand.
Damn, actor.
Now, what's in the coma that's so interesting?
Gangs.
Gangs? Oh, yeah. You ever hear of that little girl that waved at a car and she thought she knew the gangnet and then they, like, blew the car up later or something?
I missed it.
You missed that?
I missed that. Was that like a TV movie?
Yes, I think it
was. Sounds like a good TV movie.
Yeah. Tacoma is pretty bad. I like Seattle, though. Seattle's a nice town.
I was born in Bellevue.
Bellevue, really?
Yes.
Why didn't I? I've known this kid for years, and I don't even know where he was born.
Sorry. Just not really the topic of conversation.
Where were you born? Really?
I was born in Plains, Montana.
I don't think she was born right? I think she was born, like, Missouri or somewhere like that.
Missouri?
Missouri, yeah.
Missouri. Duh. I think that's where they got the word, duh.
Missouri, duh.
Joe came in, duh. That's cool. That's groovy.
Groovy, because 70s, okay.
What? 70? Oh, yeah. I might have to split this show in two, you know. We're running a little long.
Are we?
It's okay. Unless you guys need to go somewhere.
Do we have to go somewhere?
I don't know. Do we have to go somewhere?
I have to cash some checks.
You have to cash some checks?
Once again to Andy's Talk Show. This is the 30th episode of Andy's Talk Show, so if you're wondering why all the foliage and stuff is back here, thank you, Kyle.
And Joe. Turbo farming.
Well, let me introduce my guest for this week. You'll probably remember the guy in the end here is Kyle Bang Bang Riggs. Say hello, Kyle Bang Bang Riggs.
Bang Bang?
Bang Bang.
Where's the Bang Bang come from,
It's not a gun, it's a bang bang.
You were the most popular guest that that has been on the show, I think. You were on the most shows. As in popular.
And I got the most audience response.
Well, no, actually.
I always had stuff to do with my Friday. Shut up. You don't understand. I have no idea.
God.
People always say we're arguing. You're always the one to start.
We don't ever.
Shut up.
We never argue.
Fine. Pussy.
Actually, we did have the most response from you because most people were puking after most of your shows. So, on the second from the end. Second from the end is...
We have the guy with the original set, the colored Pepsi. Who came up with that?
The colored Pepsi. You'll probably remember him from show number 8.
Joe Richards. Know this stuff?
Yeah.
What show numbers were I at?
You were on 10 through like 14,
give me a
I think.
Shot, yeah. 14.
Hmm. Anyway. And then third, right in the middle there, Ian Carlson. He was the painter. He was on show number 0 and numbers... You were on 3, 0, and 30.
What's up with the 0?
30.
0,
30.
What show
number?
0, 1,
30? No, you were on 0.
Oh, 1, 2, 3.
See, it goes 0, 1, 2, 3. See, we have a secret episode. Hey, nope. What did I tell you? Stay after class. You're going to have to clean up the chalkboards. All right. And on the end with the flowery shirt there is Shannon. She's never been on the show, so she's new.
She was on the show.
You never sit spread-legged in front of a camera because, you know, you get that angst. I don't want to talk about it.
Well, let's just not talk about it then.
Yeah, let's just look on the monitor.
Let's get a close-up of that. Anyway, yeah, we mistaped you. There wasn't any audio on that, and I'm very sincerely sorry about that.
No, you're not.
It was Kyle.
I know, because I was in the back, and he was just going, oh, good, we won't have to show her show.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. On the very end is Emma Dennis. She's been on several shows. I think she was like 10 through 14 or 16. I think she's been on quite a few of them. And Emma Dennis. And okay, let's start with you two. Now you guys were in a car wreck. What
we're
is
limping.
It?
We're limping. We're crippled.
Crippled.
We're the CCC.
Crazy crusty cripples.
Yes. Hey, shut up.
Dude, Andy, that looks like a used condom on the floor.
Hey, that was a joke.
What is that?
No, that is...
Actually, that is twine.
It does.
I'm sorry. It's...
Oh, from this angle, it's just... Oh,
it's dry.
Yeah, dude.
I'm sorry, I was here before. And
it's very bad.
Kyle isn't expecting it. Oh, my word. We're going to run
like
13 minutes, right, time. Jake?
Yeah,
that's right.
Okay, so you ran into a semi, is that it?
It wasn't exactly a semi, it was a logging truck.
Oh, that's not a semi.
Okay, so a logging truck, was it like a GMC or something like that?
What was it?
Or was it like a Kenwood?
What is it?
It was a Peterbilt.
Mack
truck.
Where'd they come up with that name?
Because Peterbilt did.
Peterbilt. Yeah, that's intelligent.
Well, you know, old truckers never die. They just get a new Peterbilt.
Just like my puppy.
Oh, my. Hey, hands off my puppy. The Spuds are our mechanic here. Actually, our mascot. Hey, no barking. Other guests here. Ian, so you're a sophomore in college this year, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Why?
Why?
Yes.
You're in college?
It's just the easiest thing to do.
Oh.
I mean, it's there's nothing else to do. And, like, you made me.
I made you?
Uh-huh. I mean, you know, I have to be better than you, and the only way to be better than you is to stay ahead of you.
Okay.
I suppose.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well.
How are you liking college? What are you majoring in?
I'm a CS major.
What is a CS?
Computer science.
See, I knew that. I was just asking him to hear it.
Oh, that's for all those people that don't know what CS stands for.
You're a very smart person, by the way, and I hate you because of it.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, he gets in front of the keyboard, and it's like...
bleep, bleep.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I know. I'm very good at it.
Uh-huh.
Very good on the computer.
Yeah.
Type.
What are you going to do? Hurt me, Andrew?
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. We're going to fight on air.
Andy, by the way...
Is Kyle a loudmouth?
It's time to jump.
By the way, Andy...
Hey, Andy, where's that tape? Give me that. It's definitely some
we could use that.
We
forgot to do that number one guy thing.
Oh, we've done that for one.
Oops.
Yes, Kyle, it's sticky on one side.
Excuse me, Kyle.
Don't! That's the side that goes over the mouth. Just like
calling your name.
He's gonna be playing with tape.
He needs to own about 10 rolls of this.
Just stick it on there. Just kind of
stick it on there and like shove it on.
Plaster it on.
Is that how many?
What is Ian's class?
Joe, what are you majoring in college? I know you're a freshman.
He's a freshman.
Actually, University I'm not of Montana. A freshman. I'm a first-year college student.
Yeah, there you go. So first-year college student. Which means exactly what?
That I'm a freshman.
Well, I'm ready to go.
Where are you going?
Nowhere.
I knew that. Woo, effects. Do it again, Drake.
Looky.
What are you majoring in, by the way?
That would be drama.
Drama? Yes.
Well, sort of.
How do you know when all the rehearsals, you know, like, for the triads and stuff like that? Joe Dreiling was telling me, who was supposed to be here, but neglected to, I forgot to tell him that I was an idiot.
You didn't tell her that?
No, I didn't tell her
that. Anyway, what was your question? Besides, you're an idiot?
You know about all this, you're very involved in this drama thing, and you seem to know everything about it. How? I mean, college is very confusing just registering, but you seem to know twofold that.
Yeah, it does, true. It's
share your feelings. Well, actually, you know what?
Come on, share it.
Share your feelings.
Most of the stuff, you know, have you seen the call board, Andy? I know, I've seen you in there, you know, in that building once in a while.
Yeah.
There's a thing called the car board. Well, that's where all the auditions are, and they're pretty much done, and, you know, I got cut from my first acting class, actually.
Really? You tried out for it and you were cut?
For a class. To teach me how to act, and I got
to. Well,
they're gonna teach you to cut. Oh, well, thank you for coming down.
Carolyn,
no, get out.
Bye, dude. I'm crippled. Look at my face.
Bye, man.
Oh, and their phone numbers are. No.
Bye.
Let's see your
tattoo. Bye, guys. I do have her phone number. I can read it over there. Hey.
You know, you know, I hate to do this.
All right.
I just noticed.
Let me adjust the camera.
What are you...
What?
He's adjusting the camera. Now we don't have to look at these seats.
Right.
Yeah!
Like, that's all angle. Yeah! Like the David Letterman show. Did you just, like, move from NBC or something, Andy?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. I wasn't sure if that was you or somebody else that was famous.
No, it was me.
Somebody worth watching.
NBC, the National Broadcasting Institute.
You don't know how much...
That's NBI.
How much cleaner I feel right now. I feel so fulfilled.
Jeez.
So. You haven't explained this. Friction between.
I can't really on television.
Was there a lot of friction?
Yeah, there was.
And it started from there to just.
Kyle,
is
this
kind of like. Andy,
is this going to air after 9 o'clock?
Yes, it is.
Oh, then. Well, but is there any time it's going to air before 9 o'clock?
Yes.
Okay, well, then we can't explain it.
Well, you can cut that part out. Because
Well, no, actually, I can't. Actually,
we have 5 minutes.
This part?
5 minutes. Let me ask some questions here.
I noticed.
I'm a dead man, you know. I'm a dead man.
He's wearing a Massimo shirt.
Get this
thing. She doesn't play volleyball.
No.
And
thank you.
It's kind of interesting because, you know, a lot of people don't really know this, but the stretch. That's a volleyball fan.
And I hate kids that wear stuff and don't play
volleyball.
I got my Massimo shirt on, but I play volleyball. Pro Beach Volleyball.
There's a tournament this week.
There's a tournament this weekend.
You play the Pro Beach Volleyball.
Yeah, Joe and I do.
Yeah.
Joe and I are like a team.
Yeah. I'm trying to, you know, teach him, take him under my wing.
Oh, yeah.
Teach him a little bit about.
But anyways, yeah, it's... But okay. All you kids that were Stussy and Massimo that don't play volleyball, you're losers.
That was pretty good.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Well, you guys... Since it's just us guys now for the 30th episode, which is not going that well.
No, it's going well. It's going well. It's going well at this point. It's going well at this point.
It's been us guys like the whole show.
Yeah, it's been us guys.
They were awful quiet.
Yeah, I'm so glad too. You have
very easy. Let's critique how they're dressed. I thought her bandage. The
bandage.
I'll do the thing from Cuffs. They're really, you know, pretty.
I'm going gonna have to cut out this entire section, you know.
Well, are you gonna? Because then I could joke and tell my story, but I really
I don't
hope
think
he doesn't.
Tell okay, me okay, later.
Tell. Yeah, we'll tell him later.
Later.
Off camera.
So I was like really
I'm
late.
I'm sure if
Joe
a certain person's watching this, she
Jennifer
knows
Livingston.
What's going on.
Jennifer Livingston was supposed to be here.
Jennifer was coming down too.
Yeah.
Hey, got,
Joe
got
Dryling, Jeanette Zarco, and Joe, they were all here.
What are you
Ian
doing?
Saw them.
You're pretty good at that.
When were they here? They were here like 4:30 and I got here like 4:32.
Those left. Stupid horse. I mean.
Hey!
Whoops.
Secretly in love with
hey,
you. Now,
that's going to have to be a beep, I think.
How many official languages does Switzerland recognize?
Three.
Ten.
Four.
Four.
I hate that.
And the winner of this game gets a stick of gum.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
Double
B. What kind of knife did Mark carry? Mac?
It's Mac the knife.
Buck
knife. Bowie knife.
Jack knife. You'd think it was a Mark
knife. Oh, like
knife.
A Mac truck.
This Mac got him with the Jack
Mac,
knife.
Mac. Jack. Mark.
Back up.
Well, what was the category?
Onyx.
You gotta tell
us. Okay, history. Who was the founder of Ismail?
Mohammed.
Ismail.
All right. 1 point for Joe. He's.
I'm almost at that stick of gum.
That stick of gum, you can smell it, can't you?
Ask a science question.
Taste it. What kind is it, Joe?
All right, science question. What is SOS International Morse code?
Help.
Beep, 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 beep. Three dots, that's three dashes, three dots.
That's what I did.
You said it before. Beep, no, you beeped
no,
it.
No, see, I beeped it. No one got that one. Right. Another science question. Who was the first man to orbit the Earth?
Yuri. Yuri somebody. Yuri.
Yeah, right.
No.
Terrestrial.
No.
Gagarin?
Something like that. What's his name?
Yuri Gagarin?
Yeah, I knew it. I just couldn't pronounce it because it's that stupid Russian.
I'll give it to you. Yuri Gagarin. Was the first to orbit the Earth after Kyle Riggs. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Entertainment.
Ow!
What film?
Oh, damn it.
You can't say that either, you.
We can't say any of this. Jake, don't flip me off. Okay. What
one
films
minute.
Featured
oh.
character Popeye? Hey. Popeye Doyle?
Popeye and olive oil, dude.
No. Popeye Doyle.
What movie?
Yeah.
This is probably.
Movies.
Is Popeye,
movie?
I don't know.
French Connection, too.
And who was in that? Gene Hackman.
Popeye the Wall.
Gene Hackman.
Gene
Hackman.
What is this, the Bat Show or something like the Batman, you know? Crooked. What victim of the French Revolution was known as the Widow Carpet and the Baker's Wife? I can't even pronounce it.
Jean-Luc Picard.
The Stone Temple Pilots. What's the favorite group this year? MTV Music Awards probably already gone.
Pearl Jam
Pearl
is.
Jam, I think
Pearl Jam.
They're gonna sweep. Do you think?
Yeah, Pearl Jam's gonna sweep.
Yep.
It's tomorrow.
If you haven't, it's tomorrow. But by the time this
Pearl
is
Jam
broadcast,
album.
Yeah,
or
new Pearl Jam
fest,
album comes
September
out September 7th. September 7th, the new Pearl Jam album.
Really?
What's it called? It's called.
I don't know.
Something like that.
It's like one word.
Wasn't Nirvana's next album supposed to?
I don't like Nirvana.
Who cares?
Well, they like they had a like inner stone Rolling Stone like critique.
You can buy a new album now. That's Nirvana and Pearl Jam live. Don't
okay.
you get smart?
Well,
with
I see by my watch that we're just
that
about
minute.
Out of time.
Get that damn thing off of my face now.
Gotta go. All right, thanks you guys
you
for
go
coming down.
I'll take over the show.
And don't forget Emma's tattoo.
I'll be rolling the gun.
What are you supposed to talk about?
Schools are cool, especially up on. No, I don't want to talk about it. But
number 30 is done with. God forbid there's a 31.
Can we do another one?
Yeah!
Go back
to that way, I'll take over.